acoustic neuromas, also known as vestibular schwannomas, some people call it vestibular neuromas, but the common terminology is acoustic neuroma. It's a very unique tumor, and this tumor is coming off of the acoustic or vestibular nerve. You have two nerves that are coming from in that area. One segment of it is for your hearing, the other segment of it is for your balance. These tumors happen at the back of the head, where what we call the cerebellopontine angle. The good news is that most of these tumors are benign. So we're not talking about a cancerous process, we're not talking about a malignancy, we're talking about a benign tumor. However, what gives people trouble with this tumor is that it's in a very confined space. A lot of nerves are going through, a lot of arteries are going through. More importantly, what's the organ in the brain here called the brainstem, or the part of the brain called the brainstem, is located. If these vestibular schwannomas or acoustic neuromas get large enough, they're now starting to press on that part of the brain called the brainstem. They start pressing on the nerves and arteries. Most patients with acoustic neuromas, and the way that they get diagnosed, is they have hearing decrease, they can have ringing in the ear, they can have imbalance. Those are the most common things. Most of the time it's one side, but we have seen subset of patients that have both sides. Acoustic neuromas are in a very important and intricate area, so we give it a lot of thought process in a multidisciplinary fashion. Now, the treatments are several. Some patients, because of the size of it, it could be because the fact that it's not pressing on any types of main structures in the brainstem, it's an incidental finding. It could be that they're elderly. We say we could just watch those, meaning that we will monitor them, make sure there's no growth. The other treatment is surgery, and to be very specific, it's microsurgery. Now, the other strategy for treatment of these acoustic neuromas are radiation therapy. There are technology where they focus the radiation through what's called stereotactic radiosurgery. So it's a focused area just to the tumor, not to the surrounding area, and that would freeze the tumor in place, and in some cases it would actually shrink the tumor. Now, let's say that if the recommendation is for you to have surgery, there are different approaches to the surgery of this. There is a surgery where it's called a retro-sigmoid craniotomy. So what that means is that we are going to try to do the surgery in a way not to hurt your hearing that you have already. Now, there's no guarantee that always that there could be hearing preservation, because it depends on the size of the tumor. With larger tumors, the level of hearing preservation goes down. The other method is called translabyrinthine approach. In a translabyrinthine approach, we're actually going through the bone called the mastoid bone. And in that case, there's no hearing preservation. Just by drilling that mastoid bone, the hearing will be lost. So those are the two things that you might hear, so that you can ask your surgeon more question about which approach am I gonna have. Recovery, it can take anywhere between 3 days to 4 days in the hospital. Some patients might need rehab after that to get a little bit stronger, to get their balance before they can go home. The balance is affected because by going just in this area, there's a lot of cerebrospinal fluid. When you release the cerebrospinal fluid, you're manipulating this area. Inherently, the balance is a little bit worse after surgery, but it does get better most of the time. After the patient is in the hospital, they're discharged to either home, rehab, and then they come in for about 10 days. We check the incision, make sure that there's no cerebrospinal fluid leakage, and total recovery most of the time takes about 6 weeks for a patient to feel much better, back to their routine activities.